Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Thursday, February 15th, 2018. And it's a great day to be alive, y'all. And I come to you, and I know you guys probably feel the same way that I do, with somewhat of a heavy heart. You know, we're in South Carolina, and a coworker of mine yesterday, you know, brought to my attention of the tragedy that was happening in Broward County yesterday. And it was, obviously, it was really sad to hear the horrific news of what occurred yesterday. So before we really get started, I just want to take a moment and acknowledge the young people who senselessly, at least from my perspective, and I know God sees things differently. Sometimes, you know, it's a struggle to understand how those things are allowed to happen. But nevertheless, they do happen. And it's just a tragic event. So let's keep our hearts towards the families of the victims, of everyone who lost their lives yesterday in that tragic event. My name is Kevin Lewis, and I'm standing in once again for my wife, Rhonda Lewis. Hello, Nisha. Hello, Ronnie. Hey, Ronnie, how are you? Good to see you. It's been a minute. Next time I come down there, I got to make sure I swing through the SBC and see you guys and tell your husband I said hello. But it kind of threw me a little bit this morning. But we have to push for good morning, Lenine. We're gonna push through this morning. I want to kind of pick up on something somewhere or where I left off, I think, the last time that I spoke with you guys. I know I issued, good morning, Karen. I know that I issued a challenge, a meat-free, I think this week was supposed to be a meat-free challenge. I'm not sure how many of you are actually doing it. But one thing that I know about this is that this is a personal journey, right? And so we're laying down some information that we believe is beneficial for you, but, you know, we, like the old saying goes, hey, Stephanie, you can lead the horse to the water, but you can't make them drink. So, you know, seed swords. So we're sowing seed right now, and we pray that, you know, something or someone will come along and water that seed, if not you, and that it will continue, it will begin to flourish in your lives. But I'm going to go ahead and move forward. Like I said, let's keep the families of the victims down there in Parkland in our hearts and minds today. And I'm going to say this last thing before I move on, but let's not just, you know, pray for them. And and Doc, I saw your post this morning. I did not realize Doc posted that both Parkland and Weston were deemed some of the safest cities in this country just a few days ago, if not yesterday. And then obviously that tragic event happened in Parkland. And from what I understand, there was another, you know, violent acts that happened at a school in Weston. So just some crazy things that are going on. So we have to really, you know, pray and see things well. And hold on one sec, let me turn off this top light. All right. Anyway, last week we were talking about As a Man Thinketh, and you know that we are on, this is the 28 days of fasting from wrong thoughts and wrong foods. So last week I issued a challenge, and the challenge is that we are, this week is a meat-free week. So I'm not sure how many of you are actually following it. Like I said, this is an individual challenge. We don't have to be perfect. I'm not saying if you don't have to be perfect, Just be committed. Committed to what? Committed to improving yourself, because you have been given dominion, just as I and everyone else have, over the bodies that we live in. Now, many times we operate out of ignorance, and I don't mean that in a negative way. We operate in something that we just don't know, and because see, we actually create our thoughts and choose our thoughts, or they're given to us by someone else. And what I mean by that is, most of us operate, and especially in the ways that we eat and the way that we think, we don't realize the significance of it. But when we allow information into us, our subconscious mind brings that in and it thinks that it's real, and then it starts to produce after its own kind. So we're actually either producing from what we want to have in our lives, or we're receiving our information from an outside source, and then we're reproducing that. Okay, that's why multi-billion dollar organizations pay millions of dollars for commercials, because they actually work. They want to influence behavior. Okay, Facebook is also a perfect example of this. You know, when we look back on the last election, I don't know if you guys follow politics, but they're saying that, you know, a lot of misinformation was given and people believed it and they voted certain ways based on the misinformation. So we really have to guard our hearts and our minds when information comes in and learn to discern what is truth and what is not. So I just want to jump in real quick, and I'm going to be reading a little bit because there's some points here that I don't want to miss. So, and it's called, we're talking about self-talk, right? What are we saying to ourselves, right? It says, talking to oneself is a habit that everyone indulges in. We can no more stop talking to ourselves than we can stop eating or drinking, right? All that we can do is to control the nature and the direction of our inner conversation, okay? Most of us are totally unaware of the fact that our inner conversations are actually the causes of the very life that we are experiencing. See, the world is actually a magic circle of possible mental conversations. And like I was saying, what conversation are you having with yourself? Is it based on something that you desire to have in your life, or is it based on some information that somebody else gave you? Right? Those people that are disciplined enough to stick with the vision that they have received from God, they're the ones that we marvel at because we see their success, right? They're the ones that actually changed the world. They're the ones who actually said, you know what? Man has never flown before, but what does that have to do with me? I have a vision that of seeing man fly in a machine. And as a result of that, horse and buggies and train travel is no longer the primary mode of transportation for distance travelers, right? Someone had the vision. Right? So sometimes we take these things for granted and we think that it's coming from, I don't know where we imagine it come from, but all of us here have the same capacity if we would simply trust and follow the vision that God has given us and then control what we're thinking about. Right? But we give that stuff over so easily to other people, and then we live our lives and we grow old and we realize I never accomplished the things that were in my heart. So we don't want that to be your situation. I certainly don't want it to be mine. So what do we have to do? Take control, right? So we must begin to take life consciously. For the solution of all problems lies just in this. The second man, the Lord from heaven in all of us, is trying to become self-conscious in the body, that he may be about his Father's business, right? And what are his labors? Is to imitate his Father. Right? Just to imitate his Father and become master of the word, master of his inner talking, that he may mold this world of ours into the likeness of the kingdom of love. Right? So what are we doing today? Are we molding our world, right, to fashion that which God has placed in our hearts? Or are we just in the world? But the Bible clearly tells us that we are in the world, but not of it. See, because as long as there is no change in our inner talk, our personal history of man, it actually remains the same. So we cannot continue to go forward without challenging that which we're thinking about. Because to attempt to change the world before we change our inner talking is to struggle against the very nature of things, right? Because man could go round and round in the same circle of disappointments and misfortunes Not seeing them as caused by his own negative inner talking, but as caused by others, right? Now, this may seem far-fetched, but just the other day I told a story about a lady who went to her mentor to complain about the actions of her boss. And what she really was looking for was someone to have pity on her and to sympathize with her situation. But a true mentor, a true man or woman of God, actually always direct you back to yourself, because everything is a result of what you're doing or not doing in most instances, right? Now, of course, we know there are some victims, but in most instances, it's a direct relationship to what you're actually doing or not doing or thinking or not thinking, right? Because as a man thinketh in his heart, so is his experience. So in the story, In the story, he told her that if that's what you're experiencing, some negative things with your boss, then you yourself, not your boss, is in need of a new mental makeup, okay? A new mental makeover. So he directed her back to herself. And so when he asked her, what was he thinking about? She said, well, every day on my way to work, I'm thinking about all the negative things that he's going to say to me, how he's going to tell me how he doesn't like my work, and how he's going to put it down, and how he won't receive my creative ideas and all of this stuff. So when she got there, guess what? Her words actually met her. They performed, right? Because our words go before us, and they actually perform and do that which we send them out to do. So if we expect that happen in our life, guess what we're going to do? We're going to experience those very things. So that's why we have to take control, right? So we're told, the prophet says, we have to be imitators of God as dear children. And how can we imitate God? Well, we are told that God calls those things that's not seen as though they were seen, and then the unseen becomes seen, right? So that's the same power that's on the inside of us. We call those things that are not seen as though they are seen, and guess what? The unseen then becomes seen. What do you want to see in your life that's not there? Then I challenge all of my brothers and sisters on this call today to actually go inside and monitor what you're thinking. And if it does not line up with the very vision that you have for your life, then you have to take control of that and dismiss that. Right? We can no longer sit around and blame anything else for the cause of what's going on in our lives. The power to me, this is Kevin, the power in the Word of God to me is that it has empowered me, right, to understand how this thing that God created actually operates, right? So we can wait and get ours in the by and by, and we all want that, right? We all want to reign in heaven forever because we're only going to be here for a limited time. But while we're here, we also want to experience the bliss of a very happy life, whatever that may be. And that's something different for everybody that's on this line. I'm not here to tell you what happiness is for you or what you desire to have in your life. That's completely what's in your heart. But whatever that is, are you experiencing it? And if it's not, then I challenge you to go back and redirect your thoughts. Lay down different tracks. Think about the things that you really desire to have in your heart and let those other things that don't benefit you and don't profit you, let them go. And I promise you, as the Word of God is true, that the very things that you think about, they will become manifest in your world. In your world, and not only your world, but in the world of your loved ones. So you guys go forth and have a wonderful Thursday. Let's not forget about our friends in Broward. Keep them in your hearts and prayers. And let's get a little political if we have to. Let's make sure we go out and vote and get folks to come in and actually help us to resolve all of these mass shootings. I was told there was anywhere from 12 to 18 shootings in schools in the first 2 months so far, and we're only halfway through February. This has to stop. So what are we thinking about? Let's see it stopped right now in the name of Jesus. With that being said, you guys go forth, have an awesome Thursday. This is Kevin.